The next tool we'll look at is the exposure tool, and it's used for fixing problems like we have in this shot here. Notice that the interior here is a little on the dark side, but not bad. You can see what's in here, but the windows are all blown out of shape. I mean, they're just way too bright outside there, so you can't see what's outside of the windows. I have another shot down here. There we go. This is exposed for the windows. You can get a little more idea of what's back there. You can see the curtain. You can see this tree over in here. A little bit of something over there. So you have a little more detail outside the windows, but you can't see what's inside. In other words, the range was too wide here for the camera to take to be able to get both of those together. Now what the exposure does, Photomerge Exposure, is it takes the best parts of those two pictures and merges those together, giving you a better overall exposure. Let's take a look at that. Now you need to have your pictures open that you want to be using, and then go up to Enhance, Photomerge, and Photomerge Exposure. Now it's going to think about it for a minute. It's going to take a look at both pictures, and it's going to pull the pieces together. There we go. And there's its first shot at that. You have pretty good exposure inside, and we can see the tree outside, and the curtain looks good over here. So it's a much better shot than we had to begin with, as you can see right down there. So real, real nice technique that it can pull those two pictures together into one picture. You can come in here and decrease the brightness on your highlights if you want to. I'll bring those down just a little bit more. You can lighten the shadows up or adjust your shadows in here. I'll bring them up just a little bit. There we go. You can increase or decrease the saturation level until you get just the effect that you want. And there's also a manual setting in here. There we go. And you can actually pick the parts of the picture that you want to pull into your final shot. Notice that the final shot is the interior lighting and the source is the exterior lighting. So I could actually come in here and try to grab just the pieces that I want, but the automatic does a very good job, so there's really no reason to use the manual on this particular tool. There you go. As you can see, it's very, very fast actually, and it allows you to do this trick down here. Now for this to work out well, you want to have a very stable camera mount, and you want to have a couple of exposures taken from the exact same place. So you'll put the camera on a tripod and then adjust your camera to take two different shots at different exposures, one exposed for your bright area, one exposed for your dark area, and you can then merge those together with this photo merge tool. Again, right there, photo merge and photo merge exposure. When you're done, click on done, and it then will give you a third picture, a third file, which is the actual merged image. There we go. There's the third picture, and you see the merged up here. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you found it useful. If you like this video, click on the like button below to let others know. You can click the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. I'm frequently uploading new training videos. Don't forget to check out my website at howtogurus.com. You can share this video with your friends and coworkers. Just click on share and then click on the social media buttons. Feel free to comment on my videos. I try to answer all comments as quickly as I can. And finally, you can get all of my training videos on DVD at howtogurus.com. Thanks again for watching.